Hey everybody! In the previous video, we defined the variance between spoofing attack scenarios. Today, I will show you a live demo with my lovely uBlocks MAT model. We will study the receiver's behavior under an asynchronous and synchronous spoofing attack. This here is a GP simulator evolution kit. It's a GPS spoofer we developed. Alongside, we have the RF accessories, RF coupler, attenuators and adapters, and cables, and two uBlocks models. That is one as a reference. We use an oscilloscope to measure the PPS signal phase offset. Now it's in the 50 nanosecond range. GNSS antennas are installed on the roof, making this a live experimentation. Let's start by configuring the target uBlocks model. Since our spoofer supports only GPS, we leave only one constellation. Okay, here you can see current fix mode, coordinates, visible satellites, position deviation map, and SNR average chart. Now it's the spoofer's turn. We're using the current almanac and ephemeris from NASA's website. Set the connection type to conducted. And we start with a synchronous or non-coherent attack scenario. The current GPS signal power of the antenna port of the model is approximate -110 dBm. Let's set the spoofer power to 10 dB more. Run. Here you notice some degradation of the signal-to-noise ratio instead of a boost. As we noted in the previous video, a non-coherent signal is perceived by the receiver as noise. To conduct a successful asynchronous attack, the original signal must be blocked. The simplest way to do that is to boost the power of the spoofer or activate a jammer for a short time. Let's add 30 dB. Look, the receiver show no fix. Let's wait a little bit. Awesome, the model uses a fake signal. Notice that the signal-to-noise ratio increased. Some engineers believe that SNR monitoring is the appropriate method for spoofing detection, but that is not the case, because it's easy to add noise to the generated signal, hence simulating any value of SNR. Let's lessen the SNR for a few satellites. I think it's obvious. And what does the oscilloscope display? An offset in 80 milliseconds. Okay, now let's perform a coherent or synchronous attack. Since our signal is identical to the genuine one, we do not need any hefty power. The spoofer gets synchronized with a live signal. The generation will start in 30 seconds. Okay, it started. Look, the receiver switched to the fake signal instantly without losing track. The average SNR increased by 10 decibels. The PPS phase offset did not change. At this point, we can shift time, coordinates, or both. Let's add 500 nanosecond PPS offset. The receiver will be slow to respond. It's needed a few minutes to adjust. Okay, I think it's clear. Why should you consider various attack scenarios? First, it falls that a coherent attack is complicated and expensive. Second, a coherent attack does not require a lot of power. It can be done with any SDR from a distance of tens of kilometers. And finally, a time server under a coherent attack will not show any errors or even warnings. You will just have an incorrect time. Stay safe and subscribe to our channel to find our latest research.